I'll be showing how to use the Word Similarity Checker. This is in Word for the web and part of Editor. This feature lets students independently check their citing and resources to make sure they're not inadvertently plagiarizing or forgetting to add their citations. Now to start out, I'm on office.com. I'll go to the plus menu here and choose New Word Document. Now a note before we get started, this is only part of the A3 or A5 M365 subscriptions. If you only have A1, this will not show up in Editor. So to start, I'm a student and I'm going to be writing a paper on the Amazon rainforest. So I'll give it a title, okay? And I'll put my image in here of the rainforest. Now I'll go start writing my paper. So I'm going to go here first to Encyclopedia Britannica. Here's a nice passage. I'll just paste that in here. And now I'll go to my good friend, Wikipedia. And here's Amazon rainforest content. I'm going to copy this. I'll just paste that in there. Okay, now I'm just going to format my text. Okay, looks like my paper's ready. Now I'm going to turn on Similarity Checker. So you can find this on the Home tab way over on the right here. You'll see Editor. It's right there in Word for the Web. It's also on the Review tab. So we've replaced the spell checking button with this next gen spell checking called Editor, and I'm going to click it right here. Now you can see that Editor has a scoring, and I'm not going to go through the corrections and refinements. I'm going to scroll down and you'll see here Similarity. Check for similarity to online sources. Okay, let's click this. It's checking. Looks like it found two similarities. So if I go here, oh, similarity to Britannica. So this uses Bing and it searches the web and makes sure that there are not exact matches of your content to what's already out there on the web. So now what's nice is I can say, oh, add in text citation. And by default, it has MLA as the citing style. I'll change that in just a moment to show the difference. But I'll choose add in text citation. And very easily, it now adds that citation right here. And it highlights this in green to show that this has been similarity checked. Now I'm going to scroll down and check this other one. Oh, this was another one that was found on Wikipedia. So I can change the citing source. I'll go from MLA and choose Chicago in this case. And I'll say add in text citation. And it added this style. Now at the bottom, what I can also do, let's say I click here and I want to copy the full citation. Maybe I'm going to be doing a bibliography. I'll say copy full citation. I'll scroll down and at my bibliography, I can paste that. And then I have a nice little source at the bottom. So that's how similarity checking works. It's quite easy. And we really encourage students in this case to check their documents before turning in. This is an independent practice for students. And a reminder, this is only available in the A3 or A5 subscriptions. It's not available in the A1 subscriptions. So if you have Editor in A1, you will not see similarity. If you found this video useful, give it a like. Now, if you want to keep up with all the latest quick tip videos that I'll keep releasing, subscribe to my channel and then just ring the bell so you get notified for all the new videos that post.